I'm Megan Carter. I'm from Cleveland, Ohio, and I'm a retail merchandising and fashion product development major. What I would define fashion is being creative, having a quirky style, being very innovative, taking risks, basically. I feel like you can describe fashion in many different ways, and I wouldn't particularly say it's just one thing, but I know particularly with my style, I like to think outside the box and be daring with my style, so it's not nothing super particular, but just being creative. When I was younger, I used to just like love fashion, and I remember specifically there being a style network on TV. It's not the same how it used to be, but I remember they used to have this one show where they would be broadcasting it from Fashion Week, and basically like you could see like different runways and different high fashion designers, and I knew then that was something that I really wanted to be into. When I was younger, I really wanted to be a fashion designer. Another thing I can do is actually draw. So I used to make my own collections and have my own like fashion book, and like and that was really fun for me, but I realized that I wasn't the best sewer or anything like that, but I still wanted to be in fashion just because I love style and being creative and putting things together. Like I really realized that I wanted to become a creative director, and what entails in that is basically coming up with the whole concept of a photo shoot, being behind the scenes. So putting the theme together, basically. So like, for example, if it was like spring theme or something like that, putting like the clothes like together, putting them on the models, figuring out the location, basically being behind the scenes and like putting everything like together on like a canvas and like creating that. So going back to why that I want to pursue fashion, it's just like really a part of like my life and like my dream. I like beautiful things, and I feel like clothing and shoes and accessories are all like beautiful things. They're like my children. My personal style has evolved over so many years. I have different phases. Like right now, like I feel like my phase, and probably just because I had the experience of going to New York and just turning 21, like that extra oomph to feel like grown. I like the whole like kind of like grown and like a little bit sexy kind of style. Before, I was really into like the 90s. Like the 90s was like really my thing. So like crop sweaters and just different things like that. Vintage, like I love vintage. I feel like with style and clothing, like not everything needs to be like brand new, you know? So I really like to combine like vintage and new together, because I feel like it adds like something to your look and makes it somewhat different. One of those questions like people always ask me, like, why do you get dressed like every day? Because like I honestly feel like when you look good, it makes you feel good, and I like to look different. I like to be out of the norm. I like to draw that attention to being different. I want to get into high fashion. Like I'm not like not commercial, not retail, like none of that. I mean like high fashion, Harper's Bazaar, Vogue, and like that's where I want to be. So I would say my one of my number one inspirations is Andre Leon Talley. He was one of the first Black also Vogue fashion editors, and I inspired to be him because as a Black female, it is really hard for us to get into the fashion industry. And I take so much pride in like my work and everything that I do, and I aspire to be someone like him because he broke the barriers and was able to get into an industry where you don't see a lot of us there. His name is also like the reasoning behind the name of my fashion blog, which is La Nouvelle Talley. La means female version, like the in French, and Nouvelle Talley is the new Tally, so it kind of like mixes into him. I want to be the next female Tally, basically. Plans for the future. One, the experience that like I had in New York was absolutely amazing. It was really hard for me to leave because it felt like home. for like one of the very like first times like ever. Obviously, I rep Cleveland forever. I love Cleveland, but New York is definitely like a place where if you want to be in fashion and be young and be innovative and different, that is like the number one place to go. And as far as like career, that's where I want to head towards. I want to become a creative director, like I said previously, and basically like continue to build my portfolio and make connections with people. Something that I did like a lot there was go to different events, and when you start going to different events, you start to become noticed, and that's basically like what I want to do. I want to keep building up my credibility, keep building up my portfolio, continue to do photo shoots, continue to do everything that I love and that I'm passionate for. Yes, I want to make $1 million, but money isn't the most like substantial thing to me. It's about actually following my dreams. So as long as I can continue to do that and ultimately become what I want to become, which is a creative director, like, then I'm happy.